Jan. Jan.
Nearby stood six stone water jars, the finest religious for ceremonial washing. each holding from 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Now, and he told them, "Now do some things to the master of the banquet." And the master of the banquet tasted. So they did so, and the master of the banquet tasted the water that had been turned into wine. He did not realize where it had come from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew. And he called the bridegroom aside and said, "Everyone brings out the choice wine first and then the cheaper wine. After the guests have had too much to drink, but you have saved the rest till now." This is the first of his miraculous signs Jesus performed at Cana in Galilee. He thus revealed his glory, and his disciples put their faith in him. After this, Jesus went. He went down to Capernaum with his mother and brothers and his disciples. There they stayed for a few days. When it was almost time for the Jewish Passover, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple courts, he found men selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and others sitting at tables exchanging money. So he made a whip out of cords and drove all from the temple area, both sheep and cattle, and scattered the coins to the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold off, he said, "Get this out of here. How dare you turn my father's house into a market?" His disciples said, "Remember that it is written, 'Zeal for your house will consume me.'" Then the Jews demanded of him, "What miraculous sign can you show us to prove your authority to all this?" Jesus said to them, "Destroy this temple and I will raise it again in 3 days." The Jews replied, "It has taken 46 years to build this temple, and you will raise it again in 3 days." But the temple he had spoken was his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples recalled what he had said, and they believed the scripture and the words that Jesus had spoken. Now while he was in Jerusalem at the Passover feast, many people saw the miraculous signs he was doing and believed in his name. But Jesus would not entrust himself to them, for he knew all men. He did not need man's testimony about man, for he knew what was in a man. Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, "Rabbi, we know you are a teacher, came from God, for no one could perform the miraculous signs you are doing if God would not."